Tutorial: how to use PianoBoard app. You'll need a smartphone, PC running Windows, cardboard, a plastic one, scissors, a few sheets of paper, printer, or if you don't have a printer, you can just paint the tracking images by hand using black marker, and the classical or digital piano. If you are not using digital piano, you'll also need glue to make ring controller. You need to print the PDF containing the special tracking images called markers. Open the app, click the printer button, and share the file to your computer, for example via email. Here's what the PDF looks like. There is a white piano marker on the top, which you need to cut and place on the top of your piano desk above the keys, or on the music stand rack if your piano doesn't have a desk. This is the calibration marker, and this is the optional ring controller marker, which you'll need only if you don't have a digital piano. The next step is to get PianoBoard Server app from Steam. Launch it and select your MIDI device from the list. You can also mark it as favorite so that it's selected as input device automatically on next run. This is specifically important if you have more than one MIDI device in this list. In order to PianoBoard app see the server app, your phone and PC must be on the same Wi-Fi network. In order to control the app, you need to place the small marker to the camera view. So for the ring controller, you just put it on your finger and put it into view before you. The menu shows on the right side of the piano, and you can just push the buttons with your finger, or use the digital piano to navigate through the menu. Take a look next. If you have PianoBoard server and digital piano, you can use the handy piano controller instead of the ring controller. Put the menu marker image on the keyboard so that the menu appears. If your computer icon is green, you will see arrows and action icons on the piano keys. Press them on your piano to trigger the corresponding actions. The first thing you need to do is the calibration. You need to do it once for your piano. Press the calibrate button to open it. There are three settings: the keyboard height position. Press it, and when the countdown appears, put the calibration marker on the piano white keys playing. After the countdown times out, the position will be saved. Press calibrate height once more to refine it. You can always reset it using the red button to the right. Press the calibrate depth button to set the front back piano position. The last setting is the keys width. You can adjust it either using the rig controller like this. You just press and move the slider and then release it, or using the piano controller. You just press plus and minus buttons. Remember to move the piano marker while setting up the keys width so that it aligns with the keys of your real piano. How to listen to a song? In the main menu there is a play pause button, which will play the song for you so that you know how it should sound and the song rhythm. Press it to start playing. Song will be played to the end and then repeat. Press it once more to pause. Press the rewind button to move to the song start. How to play a song? If you have PianoBoard server connected and the piano icon is green, you can play the song in Synthesia style. This means that the keys need to be pressed will be highlighted with orange, and the melody stops until you press all of these keys. Right keys pressed at the right time are highlighted with green. Wrong presses are highlighted with red. That's it. To choose another song, press the song's library button. Then you can navigate through the songs using up and down arrow buttons. Clicked song will be loaded into view and played. Built-on songs have classification based on difficulty. Easy ones are green, medium are orange, and hard are red. You can also click import button to switch to your own songs, and here's how to add them. You can add your own songs in two ways. Pick a song from your phone using add new song button, or upload it from server using corresponding button. Note that this feature requires an in-app purchase.